Hello. Today we are going to cover the fifth unit of NCERT Geography Class 6, Domains of Earth. Let's get in. We have four domains on Earth: lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere, and biosphere. Surface of Earth, otherwise said as crust portion of Earth, is called as lithosphere. Earth's lithosphere is divided into two types. One is landmass and the other one is ocean basis. The solid and rigid land portion of Earth is said as landmass. All the continents and the islands we have on Earth are said as landmass. Earth has seven continents. Those are Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Europe, Australia, and Antarctica. The tallest mountain on Earth is Mount Everest, and its elevation point is 8,848 meters from sea level. The sea surface is common everywhere, so we measure the land elevation from that particular point. And the other lithosphere type is ocean basis. They are found under the sea. This is the world map. All the continents of Earth come under the landmass region. Likewise, there are oceans and it surrounds the landmass. And now let's see the continents one by one. The first continent we are going to see is Asia. It falls on the eastern hemisphere of Earth. It's largest in size and it covers 1/3 of the Earth's landmass. Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle passes this continent. And on the west of Asia, there is Ural Mountains. This mountain separates Asia from Europe. The areas of Europe and Asia combined together is said as Eurasia. The next one is Africa, and it's the second largest continent next to Asia by size. The world's hottest desert Sahara and longest river Nile lie here. Equator cut this continent almost in its center. Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn also runs through it, through this continent. And it's the only continent where all three pass together. Next comes North America. It's the third largest continent by size. It's bounded by North Pacific Ocean, Arctic Ocean, and North Atlantic Ocean. Arctic Circle and Tropic of Cancer passes through North America. And this continent, it connects with South America through a narrow strip of land said as Isthmus of Panama. Isthmus is nothing but a piece of land that connects two large land masses. Similarly, we have straits. It's a narrow strip of water that connect two large water bodies. For example, Bulk Strait, Sri Lanka. The next continent we are going to cover is South America. Equator and Tropic of Capricorn passes here. It has the world's longest mountain range, Andes, and largest river, Amazon. This is Europe. It's smaller than Asia and surrounded by water on all sides. It has Arctic Ocean in north, Atlantic Ocean at west, Mediterranean Sea, Black Sea, and Caspian Sea towards its south. The next one is Australia. It's the smallest continent on Earth. It comes under southern hemisphere and surrounded by water on all sides. Therefore, it is said as island continent. And the last one is Antarctica. It comes under southern hemisphere. South Pole is almost in the center of Antarctica. As it is a polar region, it's completely covered with glacier. Due to its extreme weather condition, there are no permanent human settlements. However, many countries have their research stations here. India too have its research station. They are Dakshin Gangotri and Maitri. The second domain that we are going to cover is hydrosphere. Our Earth is covered by 71% water and 29% of land. That's why it's called a blue planet. Water in its all form is said as hydrosphere, that is river, ocean, streams, underground water, water vapor around us, all said to be hydrosphere. More than 97% of Earth's water is in ocean. As it's salty, it can't be consumed. And the rest 3% is seen in the form of ice sheet, glacier, and underground. The available fresh water is a very precious resource and we should use them in a very proper manner. One of the largest form of hydrosphere is ocean, as it occupies the Earth most. All oceans are interconnected and they always have movements in them. The major three movements of oceans are waves, tides, and ocean currents. And we have five major oceans on Earth: Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Southern Ocean, and Arctic Ocean. Among them, Pacific Ocean is the largest and it's almost circular. 1/3 of Earth is covered by this ocean. The deepest point on Earth, said as Mariana Trench, lie here. The next is Atlantic Ocean and it's the second largest. It's like S shape and its coastline are indented, that is with zigzag cuts. This structure makes this ocean important in commerce point of view because of its natural harbor and port inclination. On west of Atlantic Ocean, it has North and South America, and on its east, it has Europe and Africa continents. The next is Indian Ocean. This is the only ocean named after a country. It's triangular in shape and it's bounded by Asia in north, Africa in west, and Australia in eastern side. The next comes Southern Ocean. It extends towards north till 60 degree. And the last one is Arctic Ocean. It's within Arctic Circle surrounding the North Pole. A shallow water stretch called Bering Strait connects the Arctic Ocean with Pacific Ocean. The third domain we are going to see is atmosphere. The air that surrounds us is a combination of gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, etc. Also, it protects us from harmful sun rays. The presence of air around us is said as atmosphere. There are 5 layers in atmosphere and it extends till 1600 km above. Based on the composition and other proportion, the layers of Earth vary. The lowest at layer is troposphere and this is where we reside. And above that we have stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere in sequence. 99% of air was pure. But now, due to pollution and global warming, there is a huge difference in its proportion. We need oxygen to breathe. Likewise, organisms need nitrogen for living. The carbon dioxide that we exhale are absorbed by plants and in return they provide oxygen that we need. Therefore, we need plants for our survival. Also, carbon dioxide absorbs Earth heat and keeps Earth warm. We have seen layers of atmosphere. Their density varies from layer to layer. The air density is higher in sea level and they will get decreased as we go higher and higher. That's why mountaineers carry oxygen cylinders on climbing. With this, they can prevent breathing risk. Along with density, even temperature fall as we go above. And now you would have understood why the hill regions are chill. Atmosphere always exerts some pressure on Earth and it differs from place to place. Air always moves from high pressure to low pressure areas and the moving air is called wind. And the last domain we have is biosphere. A place where air, land and water meet is said as biosphere. Biosphere comprises everything that starts from a tiny organism to a huge-sized mammal. Humans are also a part of biosphere. So by nature, all are interconnected and dependent on each other. They are connected either direct or in indirect form. Example, when forest trees are cut, the slopes of the mountain becomes weak and erode very quickly. This results in soil erosion and large land breakouts. People who reside here are the often who lose their lives. Because the roots of trees hold the soil tightly, but in absence of them, the soil becomes fragile and fall. Sometimes due to natural calamities like earthquakes, tsunami, etc., there will be a shift and sink in land surface. It's beyond our control. However, soil erosion due to deforestation were caused majorly by humans. A similar environmental degradation occurred due to water pollution and it disturbs the ecosystem of other creatures too. And another example is emissions from factories. They emit large carbon dioxide. Earth needs carbon dioxide, but if it exceeds the level, it increases the global temperature, making Earth more hot and warm. So, utilizing the Earth's resource at best without disturbing the ecosystem keeps our planet green and healthy in the long run. So, balance is the key. Hope the lesson is useful and I will see you on the next good video.